Today we are going to tag a bar chart using Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. Now there are a couple of different ways you can tag a bar chart, one of which is to tag the entire thing as a figure element and provide detailed alternate text. Another method, if you have the right kind of data, you can actually tag the different pieces of text in P tags and do this special trick where we put some of the data behind a span tag so that a user using assistive technology can more appropriately navigate to the content. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison, and let's jump right in. I'm going to select the reading order tool, and this is what we're going to do. We're going to use the reading order tool to select some text and mark it as text paragraph. And then we're going to take these numbers and mark them as text paragraph. And we also have data labels for all of this content at the top. We have very likely, not very likely, don't know, and already done. So what I want to do, and we have some other text. Let's go ahead and tag a little bit of this. Let's make it a heading level 2, and let's find out where we are. All right, we have those data points there. Let's move this heading level 2 up under that paragraph tag. And then this is how we're going to structure this data. So the first thing we're going to do, this first label, use greener energy, I'm actually going to make this a heading level 3. And then the various P tags that are here, we have 75, 10, 7, and 8. And what I'm going to do is actually adjust the actual text on this. So to make this content accessible, we need to indicate to the user what the data point is. In this case, this light blue is for very likely or likely in terms of a percentage. So what we are going to do is right-click the P tag, select properties, and we are going to add some actual text in. And what we are going to say is 75% of respondents selected very likely or like, and then select close. And we're gonna do the same thing for this P tag on number 10. We are going to right-click the P tag, select properties, and update the actual text to provide the data and the label. So we will say 10% of respondents selected not very likely or not at all likely, and then select close. And then let's take our number 7, right click it, properties, give it some actual text. 7% indicated they don't know. And then let's do the 8%. 8% indicated already done, and select close. We then would simply tag the rest of these. So we could do that using the reading order tool, selecting it. We know this is gonna be a heading level 3, P tag, and P tags for all of these numbers. I'm just using the reading order tool. Now, there's definitely going to be some color contrast failures on this particular bar graph. I don't have access to the source file, so unfortunately for now, I have to leave that error in here. But more importantly, this is an effective method to tag bar charts so that your data is included. And then finally, I'm also going to artifact all of these labels at the top. That way they don't get in the way of the reading. And then let's finish off this other tagging. I am going to move the tags into the correct order. So now we have this heading level 2, heading 3, P tag with our data. And then we're gonna do the same thing here, electric vehicles. And then we need to update the actual text of this P tag. So again, to do that, I'm going to right click the P tag, select properties, and update our actual text to say 68% indicated very likely or likely, close. Properties for the next one, 24% indicated not very likely, not likely at all. And yes, this is time consuming. 5% indicated they don't know. And then the last one will be 3% indicated already done. All right, so that is how I would tag this bar chart. Now, another thing that I've seen people do, which it really depends on the data you are working with, is to tag the content all as a single figure. Now, this is a really bad example to do that with because there's so much text. But with that said, I'm going to run through it anyways, just so you can see what it's like if you have a more simple bar chart and you're not able to extract any of the text from. So to do that, we would grab our reading order tool and essentially grab the entire thing and mark it as a figure element. Now that's gonna undo all that work I did previously in the video, but then we can right click the figure tag, select properties, and this is where you then need to type everything out. So we would give our labels like this figure represents survey results for how likely their business would make any changes to help tackle climate change. And then this is where you would begin to put in the data. So we would do things like use greener energy. 75% said very likely, and on and on and on. So I think my first method is better, but again, that's for this particular set of data. If you had a different chart, you might do a different style of tagging. It just really depends on the content you're working with. I hope you enjoyed today's video on a couple of different methods on how to tag a bar chart in Adobe Acrobat Pro DC. Now, if you've decided you don't want to deal with any of these problems, check out the links in the description of this video to find out how I can help you get accessible. As always, I can be your personal accessibility expert. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.